a pretty standard story. I wanted to become a graphic designer because I was very interested in art, still am. And I just thought that that's what I would do in my higher studies. But destiny had something else planned for me. And I came across this audition when I was just finishing my college. So even before my final exams, which was for a football show. And that was it. It just led to, you know, time in front of the camera and opportunity after opportunity in sports, which was something that I was interested in, like a normal person who likes sports. I didn't think it would become a career. So it's kind of been like maybe an accident waiting to happen that just developed into, you know, 12 years now of doing this. Yeah. So look, the thing is, I can't really ask the question as to how I was received, because you'll have to ask other people that question, right? It's not something that I particularly worried about or concentrated on. When I entered this field, whether it was football, cricket, or just, let's keep it sports broadcasters general, I didn't think of myself as a woman presenter, and I still don't. And I work in an organization that doesn't treat me as a woman presenter. You're a sports presenter, and we have the same responsibilities, male or female. I work with men and women in this field. They're women producers, they're male producers. I don't think gender really matters. That's the attitude that I had even at the start, and that's the attitude I'll continue to have. So how other people perceive you, it's difficult to, in a sense, assess. And also, I'm not one of those who's too worried about trying to consciously break that stereotype. No, I'm just doing what I do. This is my attitude. And if other people can replicate it, irrespective of gender, and realize that it's a role, it doesn't matter whether, after all, there are women who play cricket for the country, right? So it doesn't mean that women can't play cricket, or for that matter, talk about cricket. So I think that's a very outdated way of looking at it, as being a woman presenter in a man's world. I don't think it's a man's world. This is the sports field, and they're men and women athletes. And we have to have skills as a television broadcaster or as a host. And your gender just doesn't play an equation into that. I don't pay attention to them. It's not even about making a conscious effort. You're right. I am human. There will be situations where things do infiltrate. It happens to everyone. And you have to know that if you put yourself out there on social media, you're opening up yourself to not just a whole lot of validation, but also a whole lot of negativity. I block comments on Instagram. I get asked by people all the time saying that, you know, we just want to say nice things. I'm like, look, I appreciate that, but I don't need the validation. I put pictures up there because it's fun. And I don't need the likes. I mean, I really appreciate the likes. I don't need the negativity, right? So with that, I guess you take a hit. You don't hear, you know, there are people out there who really have a lot of positive things to say. And I feel that I maybe have blocked that out consciously, because, you know, that's what we try and do, right? We try and protect ourselves from bad words or negative thoughts. And I think even being a normal person, you try and live your life like that. I have a very strong support system. My family, my husband's, my organization over here. So it's okay. Keep on hating, it's fine. At least you're thinking about me, right? I'm really looking forward to seeing how we can take it a different level. You know, last year was an opportunity for a lot of us to do it for the first time. And we tried a lot of different things, and some things worked and some things didn't. This year we have more of a sure footing, and it's always exciting to challenge yourself to take it one step higher. So whether it is introducing more regional channels and languages, more than the languages, we've introduced the channels this time, getting new faces on board. It's always, and these are people who literally just played the game. So getting them as broadcasters and commentators in our select dugout will be, I think, fascinating. And we're doing something different this year, where every Sunday you will have a completely different type of show, which will be around the game, because the ethos of an IPL, and that is one thing that has been there for years, is that this is entertainment for families. And that is something that we are really going to stick to this year as well. So yeah, we'll bring you the cricket, and we'll bring you the analysis, and we'll bring you, you know, your own personalized stories when it comes to your teams. But we'd also stick to the core of what makes this IPL beat. The heartbeat of it, after all, is the fans. So I think that's our biggest challenge this year, and the one we're most looking forward to this year. You know, one of the things we do before we go live is to try and de-escalate the pressure of going live. And that's usually like someone will tell a joke, or you'll have a laugh, or you know, you'll just share something. And that person is Sunil Gavaskar. and to be someone who is such a legend of the game, who's an icon. He's a living legend, don't get that wrong. He's an icon. You know, when we present Test cricket, I mean, we look at all the firsts that have been achieved by a Test cricketer, Sunil Gavaskar's name is always there and he's sitting in your studio. But that man is so approachable, he is so funny, he is so switched on, he is such a thorough professional that he is one of the persons that I have learned so much from. And he's also the person who puts all of us in a good mood before we go on air. And he'll crack a joke out of nowhere, you know? And I think he's someone, that attitude is something that I want to be able to replicate as a broadcaster as well. Because being serious about your job and yet learning to enjoy it and have fun of it, and he's been doing it for 30 years, yeah, that's something that I like to learn from. Biggest thing is, to take gender out of the equation. I come from a family that supported that. I work in an organization that supported that. If you feel that you're working in an organization that doesn't necessarily support that and you feel like you're being typecast, it's not worth it. So if you can get the same responsibilities that your male colleagues do, and if you set yourself the same standards, which means that you must live up to the same expectations and get the same criticism, that's one great step. The second thing is that I think I was very fearless with the opportunities that came my way, in the sense that I wasn't afraid of failure. And because of that, I have been so fortunate to be able to host just that many World Cups or that many different sports, because had I said, no, I don't know cricket, I can't do it, I wouldn't have had this career. It's not always going to work out, right? Like IPL is one thing that didn't work out for me for a very, very long time until it finally did. I think after 10 years of IPL being there, finally I had a chance to host it. I think that's important because this is such an amazing industry, in the sense that you will get so many opportunities across so many different mediums. Now digital has become a huge space, for example. You don't have to knock someone down, male or female, to create your own space. And that's the biggest lesson, to be honest. Stuart Binney. If you say no to Stuart Binney, Roger Binney. Oh, good question. I think I'm better at hosting football, but cricket has given me everything. Whether it is my career or it is my life, my love. So, cricket. The proudest moment of my career would be the first World Cup I ever hosted, which was the Football World Cup, because I give credit to the person who really thought that I had it in me to be able to host a sport or an event of such prominence. So yes, that was my proudest moment. Oh my God, there were so many! I don't look at it as embarrassing. I mean, you had so many malfunctions and so many slip-ups and... I mean, I really honestly think I've introduced someone as Mayanti because I was so nervous. Like switch the names around, you know. But alright, listen, live TV, you're gonna have those moments. So I don't think of it or write it off as most embarrassing. It's just funny. You gotta laugh at yourself. My Game Banayega name moment was my first IPL, which was last year, because it was the one thing that was missing. And it was the one thing that I felt pushed me all these years as I've got to do it. You know, I made my peace with it, but I've got to do it. And so when I got the opportunity to do it, I did it every single day. That was my Game Banayega name moment. So let's see if I can replicate it this year.